definitely. That was the design, one play of Krishna. So that he wants to develop his more curiosity for him, his love for him. So when there is, and that's why Gurudev is hearing every day telling, don't criticize. You are not authority to check on someone's lifestyle. Who knows what is plan going on? Mind your own anarthas. Mind your own anarthas. Who knows how Gurudev, of course, something is going on. And from so many lifetimes, some impressions, they're blocking. So maybe after that blockage is over, the bhakti goes very high. The more speed, 4x speed. So if Gurudev is neglecting for some point, or we feel that he is neglecting, he's not like others putting his hands on my shoulders, or he's not calling me for something, there is some purpose. And that purpose is very subtle, because there cannot be any inauspiciousness in any activity of Śrīla Gurudeva and in the activities of Krishna. This Mangal, the abode of auspiciousness, Mangal Bhavan, and which throws all amangals, inauspiciousness out. If that is the case, Śrīla Bhaktisiddhānta Saraswatī Thakura Prabhupāda, the founder of the Gaudiya Math, so many of his prominent disciples got so much association from him. And sometimes he's just telling them to go away and preach. No need to even come to me. Śrīla Bhakti Daita Madhava Goswami Maharaj, Prabhupada gave him title Volcanic Energy. Really he was. If you read his biography, the Volcanic Energy, written by Śrīla Bharati Goswami Maharaj, we see that. And tremendous power, and so subtle in all dealings.
You hide your cup.
He, after preaching for months, want to celebrate Krishna Janmashtami with his Guru Maharaj just for one day.
I have my cup.
To hear Hari Katha from him. So he arrived in the morning, and he kept his bag, paid obeisances to Śrīla Prabhupāda, and Prabhupāda said, "So where are you going next?" And he understood what my Guru Maharaj wanted to indicate. He came to Siddha Mayapur to celebrate Janmashtami with his Guru Maharaj. And he immediately sat down. Shower, go. And there is nothing like no. Everything is yes to the. If that is the case, what I wanted to say is, if I, just one example, okay, please don't take it otherwise. If I am with Gurudev and for 1 minute Gurudev saw me and said something to me, and after 11 years I come to Gurudev and he again said something to me, that's it. I'll be considered as a neglected disciple. Then I will say, oh, Manmohan Prabhu, Shivanand Prabhu, Gaurasundar Prabhu, they are lucky. They used to go morning walks with Gurudev. Buddha used to put his hands on his shoulder, speaking to them nicely. Yes, neglected disciple. Was Śrīla Swami Maharaj neglected disciple? Only 2 interactions. So that's, that close proximity is not the barometer. Adoption of moods of Gurudev is the most important, even if it is one glance, or even if it is not that. In the example of Sri Ramanujacharya, his Guru Maharaj, Sri Yamunacharya, he left his body. And Sri Ramdasacharya approached him when he was already departed from this planet. But he established the moods of Sri Ramdasacharya. That adoption of mood is more important than any other thing. If I started speaking some of my very small little, this has nothing to do with Guru Bhakti.